We're here to talk about apps.
Oh my god, hi, you're back.
Like and subscribe.
Okay, no, stop it. Hi, welcome back to my channel. I have a very special guest today in my glam room, Mr. Mike Rosenthal on Instagram and Twitter. I call him husband. His friends call him Rosie. Come here. Come on, just come up. Jesus Christ. Continue through.
She just gave birth to a daughter.
All right, guys, so we are here today to tell you all the exciting things that go on with our phones. So I've been getting a lot of questions about favorite apps. People want to know. I always want to know what apps. Boo. Sit. You're blocking my thing. Damn. We're going to give you guys 7 categories of apps that we use in our everyday life just to kind of like help us multitask and get things done.
Where do you want to start?
Okay, so let's talk about travel because I know we both use a lot of travel stuff.
Uh-huh.
Look to the camera room. The camera's
up there. Watch your eyeline.
There. We're going to start off by talking to you guys about travel because we both travel a lot, and these are the apps that I personally use the most. So I love using Google Translate because, like you can see, the last time I used it was English to French. It's so helpful just when you're shopping or when you're trying to like order stuff at restaurants. Google Translate.
So I use an app called White Noise just to sleep because normally I sleep with white noise machines here, so now I get to travel with white noise. There's another one called Flight Aware that will give you real-time flight tracking. So if you're trying to monitor your flight, it'll show you where it is on the map, what the ETA is, if there's a delay. It'll also tell you more about the plane that they're using and will give you, I think it actually gives you some seating information. I also use the Paddy app. So if you're a scuba diver, you download the Paddy app and it keeps your license on your phone. So then if you go anywhere in the world, you have your license with you. When I'm on planes or trains or anything like that, I like to listen to either a podcast. I'll just use a podcast app.
What are some of your favorite podcasts?
I've got a few. I like Pod Save America for anything political. There's one called Covert that goes through all of the greatest and craziest covert operations around the world. There's some about food. Jordan Oaken has an amazing food podcast that I've been really into.
Another travel app that I like is Relax Melodies, because you can do white noise, but you can also do like little like animals and
those
chirping noises.
But you can hear like if it's like fake rain. Everyone...
But I like it when there's like the whale, like woo.
I know, but like every 30 seconds you hear the same woo.
Yeah.
Or if it's rain, it goes bleep, bleep, bleep.
All right, let's move on to work. So I have a ton of people on my iCal, so we've got like the away team and my assistants, and everybody shares an iCal calendar, which is super helpful. I love using Slack with our team at Way. You actually showed me this, and it's been such a game changer. 1Password, you guys.
1Password. It's awesome.
I could never remember my passwords for everything, so Mike told me just to get this app, and it literally has every password for anything I have out there.
It stores it in an encrypted vault, so most people use the same password over and over again, which is terrible, because if somebody guesses it or hacks your email or anything, then they have access
What's
to everything.
What's an encrypted vault?
So it basically stores it in a file, like a folder, and then encrypts it. So even if somebody were to take your phone, they couldn't physically get all of your passwords because it's completely encrypted.
What does that mean, encrypted?
It means it's like super jumbled up without your password. So without your, basically you create 1Password that nobody could guess and you only remember that one.
I know yours.
Just remember that one.
It's?
No.
Do you have anything for work that you use?
Yeah, so I use Photoshop for work at home and then I use Photoshop on my phone. I use one called Sunseeker.
Oh my God.
I know, it's super nerd stuff, but it's
you have
awesome.
So many apps.
Like, right
when I think you.
You
might be cheating, you find out that you have apps called Sunseeker.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm like, no, I don't think he's cheating.
Okay.
Just seeing where the sun is.
Then I have the app called Cheater. but that's not work, that's travel.
Okay.
So Sunseeker, it uses your location and will actually tell you exactly where the sun's gonna be at what time of day.
That's
and it has
cool.
a view where you can look outside and it'll show you where the sun is right now. And then I have fun stuff on set, which I guess would be kind of like...
Oh, that wasn't your fun list? What's your fun?
So fun. I have Instagranny. So it can take a picture and drop a granny in anything, which is awesome.
I have one called My Talking Pet that is brilliant. Look at this is gonna be Rue's picture and I can make it so her mouth does whatever I want it to do.
It's like Rue's talking to us, but she's not.
Is that cute?
That's super cute. This one's called iFart. And you can choose from a whole list of different ones.
Here's Why do you have that?
This is wet one.
You're a grown man. Wait, play it again. It's disgusting. What is that one called?
Wet one.
I can't. In other news, I have an app called Help Everyone. And this is Mike, it's not the time. Hope Everyone is a really cool app. You guys can put in your zip code and it'll tell you different charities that you can volunteer on your days off. And I think it's really, really smart. You can help pick up some poop from the horses. I know this is your work stuff, but this is my what I use for Instagram for photos. Mm-hmm. So obviously we all use Facetune, Mike especially. And everybody's been asking, how do I get multiple pictures on my stories? It's an app called Pic Collage. And I've been using it for like probably 6 months now and I love it. It's super easy to navigate through. So Rhea showed me this most amazing app that she uses. It's actually a food app. It's called Foodie. And you can use it, I guess people who post a lot of like pictures of food use it, but you can use it for anything. And I use Foodie all the time for like portrait pictures or if I'm taking pictures of products, like it's just so beautiful. So Foodie. Do you have anything else for photo of Mr. Photographer?
There's one called Cross Process that is another one that just kind of gives you like a vintage sort of Polaroid look. I mean, there's so many of those now. Visco is good. There's one called Nudifier that's fun and it makes it look like you're not wearing clothes.
That one is funny. We were so in a Nudifier in January.
I like Sudoku because when I'm on set and we have a little break, I'll play Sudoku.
Who do you play with?
Do you play by yourself?
Oh, really? It's like solitaire?
Yeah, kind of.
Do you have friends?
No. Another fun one is called Lumosity and it's like basically nerd games. So it's like brain games. You do have to subscribe, I think, if you want to get like all of the games and be able to use it all the time. But it's actually really fun. There's some that will work on memory, some that will work on like name recognition.
Is this why you've been getting so much smarter?
Mm-hmm.
So this is what you do when I'm gone?
This is what I do when you're doing Instagram in bed and I'm sitting.
Yeah, actually. He's always playing these weird games. And they're just mind games?
Yeah, they're mind games.
You love mind games. All right, so moving on to food. This is something that I am a huge connoisseur in. Basically, guys, this is embarrassing, but I have a food delivery app for every country that I go to. Because I just am so sick of hotel food. It's like I can only have french fries and chicken nuggets so many times. So I love, in the United States, I use Postmates, I use Caviar if you want to go for like fancier restaurants. The Shake Shack app, duh.
Shake Shack,
I use
for
all
sure.
The time. Uber Eats is great. Do you have anything else food related?
Well, New York Times Cooking, because you'll use that basically as food delivery, because I'll have her look up some of the recipes that I've been saving that I know that we'll both like.
Yeah, it's great. Yeah, basically Mike has me go to the New York Times app and then I pick out a picture of something that looks really good and he just magically knows how to make it crazy.
But it's not magic.
You're a magician. So next up, shopping apps. So I have recently discovered a few shopping apps that have been really bad for my pocket, but I love the Goat app to find any cool sneakers. Sometimes I get sneakers for you on there. And I love the RealReal app.
I like, of course, Amazon for pretty much everything.
Oh, for everything. You are literally that meme that says, I don't know who needs to hear this today, but you don't need anything from Amazon. We get Amazon every single day. It's ridiculous.
Half of it is stuff that you're asking for. That sounded good.
No, not that stuff that you want. Not what I do.
You won't need cables, we need batteries, stuff to make this camera work.
No, you're getting like wooden back scratchers and like doilies and like things that
that's
we do
your
not
back
need.
Scratcher. That's literally, if the house were to burn down, the
you
one thing you would grab on the way
out guys,
is a wooden back scratcher.
Tell me in the comment section below if your spouse is a Amazon addict.
Ticketmaster is also pretty great.
So we got our Michael McDonald tickets.
That is how we got Michael McDonald tickets.
It's sometimes good to go on Ticketmaster just to see what's coming up in your town. The Tesla app, what does that do?
Well, if you have a Tesla, it will tell you where
your car is. Oh, I got a new fun game. Let's look in each other's phones.
Battery level is.
I wanna see what else you have in here. Who's Rebecca?
Which one?
Exactly. Oh, we gotta talk about Nest Cam. We use Nest Cam, both of us, all the time. You guys, so Mike is so great about keeping the house secure and safe. And so we literally have Nest Cam all over the place. Our friends are like annoyed by it. Aging booth. Ooh, should we do this real quick?
Oh. See what you're gonna look like.
You
Let's
know
see
what?
What
I'm
for.
Gonna break the stigma of women not wanting to age. This is gonna be fine. We're going into, now we're in 2053. Let's see how I look. Oh my dear God.
Wow.
You're gonna hit that. Okay, let's do one more. I wanna see what you look like. So you're just gonna get more handsome, you have gray hair.
No.
You're gonna, ooh. No, you still look cute.
So I've been working on an app for about a year now.
Don't say too much.
It's working really well. It'll be a great tool for travelers.
It'll be helpful.
It'll be very helpful.
For people who travel. That's all you should say. Burrito Maximo.
Do laundry day.
Bye, Grammy. Is that because grandma's like fart as they walk?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Which one? Laundry day?
Laundry day.
So gross. TikTok, we need to learn how to do that one.
TikTok, we gotta learn that one. Do you have the Facebook app installed?
Yeah, you don't?
No.
Just in case I need to see what my mom's up to. Alright, I think we should try TikTok and see if we can figure it out, okay?
Okay.
We're grown adults, let's figure this thing out.
Okay.
So I'm gonna give you it's even in your face.
This one?
Funny. How do we start recording again?
Now what?
But I want to like lip sync to something. We don't know any of these songs.
Is this what the kids do?
Don't they have any songs that are from the 80s? Do you know any of these songs?
No.
Literally, we know none of the songs that are trending. Oh,
Biz
Markie. Let's find some songs from our favorite Spotify playlist we made called Anti-Boner Jams.
Mm-hmm.
What's it called?
Smash.
That one, Smash. So I'm gonna do my part and then I'll give it to you and you do your part.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me.
So now you take it.
I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kinda dumb with a finger in her.
So, my turn.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb.
We TikTok.
Wow, we're TikTok at TikTok. You don't stop. This is so fun.
We're
okay,
TikTokers.
We're TikTokers. All right, guys, so there we have it. Mike and I are professional TikTokers. You can get your phone back. So also, little handy thing, you guys, in the back of your phone, I have a card holder for business cards to be professional. What's in the back of your phone?
The back of my phone is a
Supreme case.
Interesting.
Okay, guys, thanks for watching. Those are our favorite apps that we both love. If you want to see more of Mike, let me know in the comment section below. And I had so much fun having you here today. You're an amazing guest.
Thank you.
Riveting. Oh, this is so long. I hate you so much. And if you guys have any nerds that you know, let them hit Mike up on Mr. Mike Rosenthal and he can get some more nerd apps. Maybe he wants to look and see where the moon is right now. Let him know.
Oh, actually, I do have a really good one.
Yeah, we gotta go.
Sky Guy.
Thanks, guys,
check
for watching.
Out.
Bye.
Stars.